Hi, Ante here. If you want to know exactly how Bitcoin transactions work, I've got you covered. In this video, we'll go over everything you need to know about Bitcoin transactions in less than 3 minutes. And now, as we have no time to spare, gently tap the like button and let's roll. Bitcoin is a decentralized peer-to-peer digital currency that works without intermediaries, which means that members transact among themselves over the internet. And instead of having a central authority in charge of approving transactions, there are miners who use Bitcoin's mining software to approve them by solving complex puzzles or hashes. The network members, or peers, hence peer-to-peer network, transact as follows. Once again, we'll revisit our friends Alice and Bob. Alice wants to send one Bitcoin to Bob, who had previously opened a Bitcoin address. What she needs to do is first, scan his address. Second, fill in the amount she wants to send to Bob, in this case, one Bitcoin. Third, like this video to help the YouTube algorithm. And fourth, send the transaction. When the transaction is made, it is validated and propagated through the network by the network nodes. And nodes are all computers connected to the Bitcoin network. Miners choose transactions that will be included in the next block, and they select it from the mempool, or a pool of unconfirmed or pending transactions. After all transactions of the block have been chosen, it's hashing time, and miners race against each other trying to calculate the block's hash, or a solution to the next block, which will then be included in the blockchain. And blockchain, obviously, is a chain of blocks. It contains every single transaction ever made on the network, and it is used as Bitcoin's record-keeping technology, as it keeps track of how much funds each address in the network has. Also, blocks are linked by cryptography, which means that the transactions made on the network are irreversible, since you can't change a transaction without changing the block's hash. But if you manage to maliciously change the block, you will inevitably change the blockchain, which requires massive amounts of energy. But even if you successfully change the blockchain, your success will probably be short-lived, because your new blockchain will probably get rejected by the rest of the network. And that is due to Bitcoin's consensus mechanism and the majority rule. And this is the property that gives Bitcoin such security that it has. And finally, after a certain number of block confirmations, Bob receives Alice's Bitcoin, and he is free to do with it whatever he wants. And all this is executed without banks or any other intermediaries, and very likely for a considerably smaller fee. Thanks for watching. If you like this type of video, please take a second to leave a like, as it really helps the channel grow. Stay tuned for more videos in the future. Keep mining, and I'll see you, my miners, in another block.